Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I wanted to do doing my makeup, soft spoken, and all my makeup laid out here. I think I'm going to do a Marilyn Monroe inspired makeup look. So I have been watching some Marilyn tutorials, and I think that I can pull this off, or I could at least try to do the look from the videos that I've seen. So yeah, just bear with me, and I'm going to take you step by step doing my makeup. I think I will start with the face and then move on to the eyes. This Feather Weight Protective Primer Oil-Free. This is the Tatcha. I'm going to be using two different primers, just because I know I want to have a very silky, velvety canvas, but I also want a glow, because I know Marilyn always had skin. Apparently she used Vaseline, which I won't do just because my skin is very prone to breakouts. I just wouldn't do that to myself. I do have a big jar of Vaseline, and I use it for chapped lips or very chapped eczema that I have on my finger. It's funny because it's actually just one finger that I have this eczema on, which is very strange, but so you guys can see, I'm just gently massaging this silk canvas to my face. Get it in the pores, and so that the pores can be filled nicely so it's ready for the foundation. Foundation that I decided to use for this look is the Maybelline 24 Hour Foundation. This is classic ivory, something maybe a little bit lighter than my body, but my face, obviously I use a lot of sunscreen, so my face is white compared to my body. But Marilyn Monroe is very fair. From what I see, from what I hear, she wasn't, you know, tanning at all or getting much sun, so now the Hollywood Flawless Filter. This is the Charlotte Tilbury primer or foundation. It has very little coverage, but if you have perfect skin, lucky you, it will go on nicely. Just like putting a little bit. Of course, I have to get my hair in there too. A little bit of it's just above my brows and on my cheeks, as I don't want it to be too shiny everywhere, just in these spots. Using the Beauty Blender, I'm just going to blend this out. coverage that this has is really very light, very minimal. So you won't see a big difference just with this and the primer. It's not anything to cover, it's just to perfect the skin's texture and overall longevity of the foundation. So I'm just applying throughout my face, making sure these two primers are nice blended together. You guys can see I'm in my room, but you're in a different angle now. It's the door to my room, and my little bed is right there. I've really spent some time in this room the past few days, and I've been reorganizing, trying to declutter. You know, a lot of you say I'm definitely a little mess, a little hoarder, but my shelf is now fully reorganized, and I gave a lot of products that I wasn't using away, and perfumes that I had there that weren't using. So one day I'll show you guys the room, and it actually looks a lot better, so I'm pretty proud of myself. Okay. Now I'm gonna start with foundation, but I usually like letting primer sit a little bit. Since I've been talking, I think it's at least been on for a few minutes, so shake this up a little. Okay. See how this color looks? It's a nice little pump. It's kind of a thicker formula, which I'm not really used to. I always start on the side that I have, or I need more coverage. So about here is like where I need all the coverage. And then here. I have an eczema patch that's active right now on my face. Very red and inflamed. It's right here, so I just tap some of that in there and go down the neck. Not actually down the neck, but just like this. That's the furthest I'll do when it comes to foundation or makeup. They say this is like a dupe for the Fenty foundation, which is a very nice, matte, good coverage. So I like the finish to it, but I don't think it wears the best. Like, maybe it's just because I never used the right primers, but it always, after maybe 5 hours, it kind of always looked a little bit like there was some separation or something maybe in the product. Almost like if you looked close at the skin, it looked like liney a little bit, kind of strange. So you really don't need much of this product. It's already covered my full face with a nice coverage, so I don't want to reapply anymore. Just kind of touch up here and there. Shade is definitely not perfect, but it is a little bit more similar to my body than I was expecting. I thought it was gonna be almost more like fair. But either way, once the whole look comes together, it's gonna look good. on my eyes as well. Kind of prime them for the eyeshadow look. Might as well. Ever since I've filmed the bedtime stories with the Priscilla Presley book, I've been watching clips and photos of Priscilla and Elvis, and also just Priscilla on her own too, and I'm definitely thinking of doing Priscilla Presley inspired makeup because I love her so much. I think she's so beautiful, and also the era that she is, that she was in, is after Marilyn, a little bit more like late 60s, early 70s vibes, and that's what I would want to do. The dark hair, usually had it pretty long and straightened, so I want to kind of recreate it or something. So that was the foundation. I think we have a good base right now. I'm gonna mix two concealers. Do a lighter one, which is Born This Way in Element, and Dior's Forever Skin Correct Concealer 25N. This is more my skin tone. This one's a little bit lighter. Definitely think that Marilyn had lighter, like I said, fair skin, and I think she also used lighter concealer from what it looks like, or maybe just like a cream or powder. You can see them mixed with the Dior and the Born This Way. Just going to conceal this. It's not that I have much darkness, really just overall brightens up the face and gives a little bit more youth. For some reason, that's just what I think of it. Really blend it all out with some powdered foundation. Just going in, slightly dusting this under the eyes, the eyelids, just everywhere a little bit. Not too much right now, just because I will be using finishing powder, translucent powder, at the end of all this. Okay, so I'm looking pretty matte and covered now. We will start with the eyes. So I have this Tartlet in Bloom. Still has a little cover. I'm going to use Jet Setter. I think that just might be it. Just Jet Setter in the crease. You can see that there is some nice color to it. It's very like everyday. Like so. the other eye as well. I've been having strange dreams ever since not being able to do much with the quarantine. I don't know about you guys. I know I've heard some other people that I know having weird dreams as well. I just don't know what is going on, but very vivid, very realistic. Also something that almost could never happen. So, just really strange. I'm actually gonna go in with a little bit of Red Bull and Smarty Pants. Okay. Very flat, kind of almost. I do have hooded eyes, I believe, but they're not like as hooded as Jennifer Lawrence or Blake Lively is a good explanation. They definitely do have a lot of very minimal crease. Really hooded eyes is, so they are still in that category, but I know Marilyn didn't have hooded eyes, I believe. I don't think so, so I'm just kind of trying to do what's good on my eye shape and then going from there, obviously, because we both have different eyes and face shapes with Charmer. Very light white color. I have to use the setting spray to actually spray the brush so that we're getting a good amount of white. I'm almost gonna cut the crease a little. It should be a little bit whiter than this, but for some reason this shadow is, I don't think it likes the setting spray that I used. As you can see, I'm getting a nice white color, but I need just a little more and then I'll blend this all together. We're working with, and then blending out so we look like this. I would like a little more white going up, maybe even a little higher. My eyelids are very dry lately. The weather is definitely nothing like spring here, unfortunately. It's very cold, very snowy, even for May, which is unbelievable. But it is happening, so. You guys can see. I'm gonna put the palette away for a little bit. Do some brown liner. I'll to find this with some liquid, but right now I'm just making the line. It's a nice swoop to her look. It's very strategically placed, I should say. Very bedroom eyes. See, I put some here and then some at the end. What I'm going to do is get a Q-tip and clean up the liner, and I'll be back to show you guys. So I have finished the top eyeliner. Doesn't look too bad. Never the best at making them perfect, but it's better than nothing. So for the bottom, I do know that we're gonna add another line right underneath. Very bedroom, very sultry. That's just how Marilyn Monroe did it. So I am making this line to make it look like I have very big, lush lashes on. And when I close sleepy and sexy. I'm guessing that's what the whole idea for this look is. I could do have an eyelash. I gotta make a wish. There you go. If you guys haven't done that, you should try it. All my wishes come true. Cleaning up these lines now, the bottom. You can see they're very subtle, but they are there. And grabbing a beauty blender, some of this Hourglass Fail powder. I'm just going to blend out the bottom and use the powder. Right under that sleepy bedroom eye. Also the sides of the nose. And the bottom here. Okay. The leftover will go at the top. Just massaging in there. Now, with our little contouring brush, we're going to contour. They actually did contour back in the 50s and 60s, so doing something very simple. Nice contouring line here. That's something that, maybe just right here. That's not something that Marilyn did, it looks like. You should she wanted a very elongated eye look outwards, forehead out, obviously. Whatever my face shape looks like is not always gonna be as complimentary to my face. Maybe it was to hers. When the whole looks done, I guess we'll find out. Just a very little blending up here. Mostly sticking to the contouring of the cheeks. Getting rid of the translucent powder now. Going to blush using the Charlotte Tilbury's Pillow Talk, to also use a MAC one for a little bit more of a darker blush. Mostly just using this for the little bit of shine that it does give. Like so. And we're using Blush Baby, one of my favorite MAC blushes. Little bit more like a contour. A little bit at the bottom of the chin to kind of define this. As you can see, it kind of brings my little butt chin down. Okay, we're gonna move on to eyebrows using the Anastasia Brow Definer. First with the spoolie, and then with the pencil. You guys know me, I'm not big on brows, but definitely just a little touch with the brow definer. Just enough to define them a little more, but not take away from the rest of the makeup look, I feel like brows can do sometimes on certain people, so I think I'm included in that, obviously. That's why I don't do it. Kind of a lifted look, as I'm not the best at doing brows for some reason, but Marilyn did have a nice little arch, so defining mine a little more. You can see the arch here and the arch here. Hers was obviously way more defined, but this will be good enough for now. Take a brow pencil, brushing them upwards. Same with these ones. Now I have the lip injection on. I put it on before this video, so I don't need to apply this. My lips are nice and plump, but I'm going to start with the Almost Nude Annabelle liner. And starting the line. to my lip shape, but defining the cupid's bow a little more. With this Dior very reds. Is it for the lips. Now, of course, I almost forgot about the mascara, but that's a very important part for this look because she had the very nice big lashes. I wouldn't say big, but very sleepy and cat eye like. Well, I don't have lashes, and I'm not good at even putting lashes on, so I'm using a mix of this Monsieur Big Lancôme mascara. And a mix of my everyday favorite mascara, which is the Bad Gal Bang by Benefit. So I'm really just trying to not get this in my contact, which actually kind of makes me super blind. No, but when I do get some mascara on my contact, I have to usually like take it out and clean it, or kind of go like that with my eyes so it's not staying there, the mascara. If you wear contacts, you understand what I mean right now. Yes, I did buy a Dyson. I really research on their latest hair products, and I did it. I saved a couple months from when I found it out that they were going to be releasing it, and I did buy it. So maybe I'll make a video on that. Just let me know if you want to see it. Okay, so I'm just continuing a little bit with the mascara. And then jumping right into the very luscious Bad Gal Bang, just because it's my favorite. I love how controlled this wand has. As you can see, I'm kind of bringing the mascara a little bit to the side, just to give that Marilyn cat eye look. The bottom as well. weird faces when I'm doing mascara. I think every person in history does, but sorry guys. Try not to a lot of the time, but on occasion, especially around Christmas, I'll pull out my red lips and give it a go. I was gonna curl my hair for this video because I know 50s and Marilyn is curled hair, but I didn't have the Dyson, but the Dyson, I think it just arrived. So maybe I can make a separate video or use it in another 50s style video. Think of it. I don't think I'm missing anything, of course. The lips could be a little bit more precise, and the eye makeup could be a little bit sharper, but I think she had a very soft, blurred look to her makeup and skin, which I really love and like, whatever. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Let me know what you want to see next.